something old, something new, something bald, something blue, and a sixpence for your shoe. And you know your mother loved you, you're my baby, and I love you. This is a very special moment of the day. And mommy had to create this. I actually made it for you. And I want to present this to you. And this is your lucky sixpence for your blessed Mary with you and Kevin.
So I created that for her.
And then she has another one that's from mother to daughter. Love you to the moon and back.
Natural disasters, my baby has been around for me. Kingdoms have fallen, angels be calling. None of that could ever make me leave, yeah. Every time I look into your eyes,
yeah.
Oh.
Oh,
for a thousand more. All along I believed I would find you. Time has brought your heart to me. I have loved you for a thousand years. I love you for a thousand more.
So we'll now ask the couple to exchange the vows, and we also know who is the pans in the relationship. So, therefore, we'll ask Brianna to go first.
Kevin, today is the day I become your wife, partner, and Mrs. Ellis. From today, tomorrow, and forever. Never did I imagine from our first date in DC, on that rooftop, that you would be my forever person. But then again, I did look really good.
Yeah, you did.
Even in that first date, you showed me what kind of person you were. You are kind, thoughtful, selfless, and actually timely, even though your friends from New York may say differently.
I'm better.
From that day, we were kind of inseparable. So we moved in with only 2 months of knowing each other. And everyone thought we were insane. And the fact that we lived together through COVID as a new couple really got to know each other and gain some extra pounds together.
Yes.
What really stuck out to me was how easy it was to be with you, how many memories we have made in a lifetime to go. But I never had a second guess your true feelings for me or your motives. I want to thank your family for raising such an awesome and the best man I could ever dream of. Each family member has played a major role in the man that you are today. I love that we can have fun with one another, from trying different wineries to watching Married at First Sight. I love that your family loves my family. I love that we don't have to stick to traditional roles, because Kevin is a mean cleaner, and I will continue to fill your belly. When I'm down, you try to cheer me up by being my best cheerleader or participating in TikToks. I love how you randomly hold my hand in the car and tell me how grateful you are for me. You have become the number one pet dad with 2 dogs and 2 cats, Kip, Tucker, Loki, and Misty, which means I have no doubts that you will be the best father to our future daughter, Kavana. You have shown me that no matter what, you have my back and I have your friend.
Yes.
I promise to be there for you from the good, bad, and in between, through health and wealth, and through all the endless movies you make me watch, including anime, and from the great locks. No matter what you got, I'm a spot for you. No matter how many people put in front, I'm a rock for you.
I need this to project. I am vengeance. I've lost my voice, so if you'll excuse me.
Really?
I am love. Okay. Okay. Brie. Brave. Here we are. I love you. A day made possible by our commitment to each other. I promise to continue to do the things that endear you to me, while also doing less of those things that make you look at me like I've got 2 heads. I promise to trust you. As our life manager, I know you have my back. You are my engine, always encouraging me to achieve more, to do more. Like the time you were like, let's buy a house. And I was like, there's no way on earth. Not gonna happen. Then it happened. Or the time I needed a new car, and you did all the research, and all I had to do was pick the one from a pre-selected list you created. I I can go on. But I know you are my support beam. On days I feel lost, you are my hope. You are my proctor. You are my heart. I promise to continue to be your number one quality control specialist.
Thank you.
For, of course, when she cooks. And I promise to be on time for dinner each night.
Oh, that's a big promise.
Yes. Also, let's add to our zoo Kip, Misty, Loki, and Tucker. Maybe some little humans soon.
Oh, okay.
But I'm good with another pet. And if there's another 90 Day Fiancé spinoff, we'll both be on the couch to watch the premiere. I promise to be there for you in these ways and more. Brave, somehow, some way, you always know what I need and what to do in the most timely of moments. Even if I'm worried or stressed out, you always shine bright and we get it sorted. Mm-hmm. I want to be there for you in the same way. Step by step, day by day, truly Ellis Everlasting. Mm-hmm. With you, any and everything is possible. Together we've accomplished so much. Mm-hmm. Just look at all the love, all the faces out here. Our adventure continues. Mm-hmm. Let's go!
Let's go! Thanks to the power vested in me by the Universal Life Church Mysteries, I now pronounce you wed. You can share a kiss.
Curtain by myself, and I dream it all. Ever since I was young, they said I would be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard for that hard to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changed it, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. They was never friendly, yeah. Now I'm jumping in the band, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it. Yeah, for the money I'm a savage. Yeah, how you itching like I have it. Yeah, put some running to me better. Yeah, they didn't know me last year. Yeah, everyone wanna act like they didn't call.
I am honored to speak tonight as the maid of honor of Bree. I'm not looking at her because she's gonna make me cry, and I'm trying not to. So many times people ask how Bree and I meet or have met, and it's a bit of a funny story. And if you find me later after having a couple of Kev's tea, the special drink, I'll tell you the details. But I won't go into the details right now. However, one of the best things that happened to me when I moved here about 6 years ago to DC was that I met Bree probably about a month after that. And from the moment that I met her, we were just friends. I don't remember any time from the second that we met that we were not friends. It was as if that we've always been friends. And so as a result of that, I have borne witness to all the ups and downs that comes with dating in DC. So I have lots of stories about those too. Find me later. However, when she started dating Kevin, and I think there's something really special about when you get to witness two people meeting for the first time and you get to watch their journey over time. And I happen to be very lucky enough to have borne witness to that. So I remember when those two went on their first date. I remember when they started talking to each other. I remember when she moved in with him about 2 months later. And I thought that she was insane. I thought he was insane, actually, for allowing her to move in with him. And then I was like, this guy is crazy. Brianna, stop. But I remember something distinctly when we were talking, you know, as girls do, we were talking about, she was telling me all these like wonderful things that Kevin does, right? And I was like, I don't know. And so, and one of the things that she said that have always stuck to my mind about what Kevin said was that, and I was like, Bree, are you sure? And she was like, I don't know. He said there's something about Bree. And I said, well, actually, maybe that guy's not that crazy. Because there is something about Bree, you know? To know Bree is to know that she shows you love in a really special way, because she really does show it. I think Bree is the definition. You often hear the words of love is an action, and I think Bree is the definition of that. She, as a true Leo, self-proclaimed herself as the queen of making people feel good. And that's very true. She really is the queen of making people feel good. And I think that seeing how Bree have been able to find somebody who really matches that same energy and brings that same level of wanting to make her feel good every single day has been really special. To know Kevin is to love Kevin. And I think I always joke that if you've met Kevin and you don't like him, there's something wrong with you. Like, and I mean that genuinely. Like, because there's, I can't think of anything that you could not like about Kevin. I mean, when the guy comes over to my house and I'm hosting, after 5 minutes, he's the one showing people there's the drinks, here's the fridge, can I get you something? Can I take your coat? By the end, I'm sitting down and he's hosting. It's amazing. So, all that to say, I could go on. But, however, I love you, Brianna. And I have been so honored to stand by your side through this journey of getting you to this day. You are gorgeous, the best bride I've ever seen. And I know that Kevin will love you well. And I know that you will love him well. There's plenty of people in this room that has wise words to give you. and I will let them do that. But today I will just share just one simple wish, is that you continue to love each other as well as you have already. And I know that if you do that, your future is bright. So hear, hear to the best couple that I know, to Kevin and Bree.
Good night to the bride and groom, family, loved ones, friends. My name is Devon. Today I have the honor of being Kev's best man. He was my best man 13 years ago when I got married. And today, finally, I got the chance to repay you the favor, my brother. He's also the godfather to one of my daughters, Chelsea. And I am impatiently awaiting the opportunity to repay you for that favor. I understand you have about three more kids too. Yeah, so their parents are also impatiently waiting. So you guys are going to be busy in the next few years, right? All right, at this time, I actually want to ask Quincy to come up and be with me right now, because you're going to be featured a little bit in what I got to say. Quincy is actually, this is the brotherhood right here. We go back about 26 years, all right? I've known Quincy since we were 5 years old, and we met Kevin in high school. We were about 11 years old at that time, all right? And since then, we've been brothers. We were pretty much raised in each other's homes. Our parents know each other. Kevin's house was actually the main hangout spot because he had the basketball court. And also because of Auntie Paula's delicious cooking. You know, there were times when there were about 10 of us in his house, you know, and we were always in and out of Auntie Paula's fridge and her pot. I don't know how she always managed to feed us, but Auntie Paula, God bless your heart. All right. You know, now at school, Kevin, Quincy, and I, we worked hard, we worked together, we accomplished together. And we had a lot of fun times. You know, I got stories, but we don't have time. All right, but just to say a little bit, you know, I remember our days of pranking each other at Scouts. I remember our days of playing basketball, cricket, table tennis until it was dark out. And I remember our famous song clashes. Now, for those of you who do not know what a song clash is, I want you to basically picture a Beanie Man and Bounty Killer versus battle, with Kevin in the background beatboxing and using his desk as drums, all right? So as life would have it though, Kev moved to New York close to the end of high school. Quincy came shortly after that, and I followed shortly after Quincy. Now, Kevin stayed true to his upbringing and his values, and he came to the Big Apple and he accomplished much professionally and academically, but there was one thing, as his brother, I know that he was missing, he was lacking, and he longed for, which is the right woman to share life's journey with. And it evaded him for a while, because those who know him well know that there were some pretenders that came and went along the way. Until 3 years ago, my brother met his dream girl, his Michelle Obama, his Beyonce. All right? The unmatched Mrs. Brianna Ellis. I met Brianna in 2019 when my family and I were at Disney. Bree and Kevin were there, and when he introduced me to Brianna, I was impressed. She had this warmth, this friendliness about her, very much like Kevin. And from that day onward, he would update me on the progress of their relationship, and he had nothing but good things to say about Brianna. Now for me, when I knew that this was for keeps, was when Kev called me one day and he said, you know, Bree and I bought a home together. And I said, okay, you know. And I could hear the happiness in his voice. And it wasn't just because, you know, he hit that accomplishment of buying his first home. It was because he was going to be warming that home with the woman he loves. And another indicator to me was Kev made me understand that this progressive stride of theirs, Bree was more of a driver in that stride than Kevin was. And for me, that was a testament to your maturity, Bree, your readiness to build a life with Kevin, your vision to see the good man that he is, your decisiveness in knowing what you wanted, not just for yourself, but for both of you, and your toughness and focus in going after it. All right, Kevin is a class act. He is a true gentleman. He is one of the best, if not the best man that I know. All right, he will not let your crown tilt, let alone fall. Okay? I believe I speak for all of us, though, when we say that we love you, we support you, all right? We wish you a long, happy, beautiful marriage with as many kids as you wish for yourself.
The first time I met Bree, it was at Afropunk. I was there with Tabby. And he had told me about this new girlfriend that he got, and he was bringing her to the city just to show her around. So when I first saw her, my first reaction was, my brother came back home. So I immediately started, you know. I immediately started looking at their interaction, their vibe, how the two of them were acting in. We were at Afropunk, so, you know, I was just trying to peep the vibe. And her energy was off the chain. And Kev was just being Kev. So before the end of the night, I was like, bro, I think this is the one. A little bit passed, and then I got the call that they're gonna make it official. So my first reaction was, just let me know when and I'll be there. Again, I don't want to take too much time, but man, Bree, you're now officially my sister. And I got your back, because he got mine and I got his. And that's family. And there's nothing that can come between that. I love you guys and I wish you nothing but the best.
Everyone, please raise your glasses as we toast to the bride and groom, to the bride and groom, to Kevin and Brianna. Congratulations. See, that's why I got Quincy. He's the mischievous one. Kevin is the consummate professional. I'm in between.
Best part. Oh, desire. When we wake up and then we make love, it makes me feel so nice. You're my water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the talent all I take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine of my life. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go, I follow. No matter how far. If life is a movie, then you're the best part.
Let's give it up for Ronnie.
Hi, congratulations. Thank you for having us. We wish you all of the best.
Congratulations, guys. We're so happy for you.
That's my brother. I'm another mother.
I want to wish my little sister and little brother best wishes and a long, healthy, happy birthday.
Congratulations.
That was everlasting. See, it's happening today. It's the best thing I've ever seen. I'm so happy for you guys.
In the building, Sunnyvale.
Love y'all.
We love you.
Love you.
Bye. Congratulations.
Yes. Bye.
May the force be with you.
Oh, what a night. What a night, what a night. Oh gosh, what a night. I feel good when you're wrapped up in my arms, dancing to a reggae song. Feel good, feel good. Feel good, cause your perfume isn't loud, and only I can talk about. Feel good, feel good. Feel like velvet rubbing over my skin, and then your hair dances on the machine. Wish we were alone, baby, just the two of us. Yes, every move you make gives me a rush. Whoa, oh. Wine some more, show me that love unconditionally. Make believe we're alone, just you and me. Take the profits, leave them behind. Don't let it show. Go, baby, go, baby, go, baby, go, baby, go. I feel good when you're wrapped up in my arms, dancing to a reggae song. Feel good, feel good. I feel good, cause your perfume isn't loud, that only I can talk about. Feel good, feel good. Whoa, yeah, 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 yeah. Boy, what a vibe. Love, vibe, what a vibe.
Give it up for them, give it up for them.
I sound.
State where you never find a dance floor empty and pimp street.
watch me diamond shining, looking like I robbed Liberace. It's all good, from Diego to the Bay. The city is the bomb if the city making pay. Throw up a finger if you feel the same way. Straight putting it down for California, yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. Give it up for Bree.
I do not party. I do not stay in the party. I do not stay in the party. me prefer. Class for the class, Jennifer. Glad to be class for the
Keep up the place that I told you. Feel this way, feel this way, feel this way. Put me down in my mind. It ain't easy.